With spinal muscular atrophy, because of the advances that have been made since 1995 when we first came to understand the molecular genetics of this disease, we're really now in a position to think seriously about disease-modifying therapies. But in order to determine whether something is effective or perhaps harmful as the alternative, which we obviously don't like to think about, but it must be thought about, we have to conduct clinical trials in a very rigorous format as such. We very much advocate double-blind, randomized controlled studies so that when patients are entered into a clinical trial to try to determine whether a compound or a chemical or a drug is in any way potentially effective or harmful, we have to have it in a design that is placebo-controlled, so that one arm would be receiving the active agent and the other arm in the clinical trial would be placebo. There are many different ways to design it. You could have a crossover design so that the patients are in one arm for a period of time and then they cross over to the other arm, or they may be their own control. So there are a variety of different designs, but they have to be rigorously designed and adhered to both by the investigators conducting the clinical trial and the patients who are involved in the clinical trial as such, so that we will have as good an understanding at the end of the study as to whether the drug is safe, number one, and most important, and secondly, whether it's effective, a combination of safety and effectiveness we call efficacy. So we want to determine the efficacy of the experimental agent that we're investigating as such.